Hi there, this is Andrew from Alla Vanilla, and after years of being asked, do we sell our pie crust? We finally do. We sell it in prepackaged frozen pie crust bottoms at 200 grams or tops at 320 grams. This is our pre-made. At this point, it's lard crusted, so it's not vegetarian. Perhaps down the road, we'll do a vegetarian version as well. But I'm going to show you how we roll pie crust. Been doing it for years, have developed some techniques that I think might be helpful. The first thing that you may notice in our pie crust is that it's pretty sturdy. It's very easy to work with. So if you choose to watch this video and not buy our pie crust and make your own, one thing I would advise you is most pie crust recipes call for too much water. So I typically will take the recommended amount of water in a pie crust recipe, cut it in half, and then kind of work my way up. But that's, again, the topic of a different conversation. What I like to do, and the rolling pin is your choice. I like this big, thick rolling pin, no handles. This works for me, but if you like the thinner type of handles and that works for you, that's fine. This dough is cold. We sell it frozen. I strongly recommend that you defrost it overnight in the refrigerator. Please do not put it in the microwave. It'll be impossible to work. So my hands are warm, and in order to start rolling this out, I will start banging it with the mallet. So this way, I'm stretching it out. I'm starting the process of rolling it out, but I'm not putting any warmth in it. You want to keep your pie crust cold as long as you can. You notice I'm also frequently twisting it, and you want to have just enough flour to keep the pie crust from sticking. You can always brush off excess, but you don't want to put a ton of flour down. So we're going to roll out the top first, and our tops, as I said, are 200 grams. It's just easier because you can use your pie tin to measure out your top if you haven't filled it with the crust already. So that's why we do the tops first. So the way we do it, and we'll do another video to show you how we fill our pies once they're once we fold out the crust, but I don't want my top to be much bigger around, coming close here. I don't want it to be much bigger around than the top of the pie tin. So you see it just barely sticks out here, maybe just a little bit bigger. And then you can see that, as I said, our pie crust is pretty sturdy, so I can just pick this up. I don't have to worry about it falling apart. Fairly confident that if you keep it cold and have just the right amount of flour on here, it's very easy to work with. So I'm done with this. Put it aside, put it in the refrigerator until you need it. And then we do the bottom crust. And a couple of years ago, my partner figured out that, well, let's step back here. We used to do our bottom crust differently depending upon whether it was a single crust pie with like a streusel topping or a double crust pie with either the top, the pull on top or lattice work. But we figured that it's easier just to do all the bottoms the same. And in another video later on, I'll show you how we put them together. Same thing. I'm beating this crust into a round. Flip it over. So a lot of people I know have, you know, try to roll out their crust between two pieces of plastic. And boy, I think that's just an extra effort. Again, if you decide not to use our crust, just make sure your crust is nice and dry. It has to be wet enough so that it doesn't crumble, but you don't want it to be wet. Now, if this crust were too cold, it would crack in the middle. What you can do in that case is just kind of knead your dough very briefly. To get rid of the cracks, or let it sit for a few minutes, but you don't want it to sit for too long. this is a 9-inch pie tin, okay? In order to have enough of an edge to do the sculpted, fluted, however you want to call it, edge, I need 12 inches. So have a flute dedicated yardstick, a ruler. I'm almost there. If you don't have enough, see, I can pick it up pretty easily. If you don't have enough, you don't have it rolled out enough, you're not going to have a high enough edge and your filling's going to fall out. If you roll it out too wide, let's say you did it to 13 and a half inches, your crust is going to be too thin. So this is 12. I'm going to go a little bit more. And then it's always good to have a brush around, just kind of brush off the excess. And then I do this a little bit differently. I take my roller, take the edge of the dough farthest away from me, attach it to my, and roll it out to my rolling pin, roll up, take my pie tin, and then I kind of center the rolling pin over the tin, unroll it, gently press it down. Okay, so I'm used to doing this really fast. I'm going to try to do it slow. Think of it in three turns. Your first turn is going to be to take and tuck this excess dough under to make kind of a double edge. You may notice that I'm moving. I'm a lefty, so I was going to say that I'll apologize, but I'm not going to apologize because I had to learn everything right-handed. So for all you righties out there, you do this the other way around. But you can see I'm taking my right hand, my less dominant hand, and I'm kind of moving the crust to the right as I squeeze the top. So this is my first go-around. It's kind of a braided crust, but I want a little more definition. I want a lot more strength in my crust because once you fill this, the filling is going to expand a little bit in the oven, and you want to make sure that your walls are tight and secure, or else your crust is going to go all over the oven, the pan that you've got inside. So, can you come in close here? You can see that there's some little tiny cracks here. I want to use the warmth of my hands to kind of squeeze those together. So again, I'm taking my non-dominant hand, my right hand, and moving it around. And then, so you don't want any kind of gaps like I just had there. You want those sealed off. So then, this is how I do it. Everybody's going to have a signature look. You know, my pies, I could never figure out why my pies never look like my mom's, because our fingers are different. So I do two fingers inside, one finger out, press in, and then move down one. So the second finger will go to where the first finger was. Same here, press in. You just do that all the way around. Got a little crack here. I want to make sure I close that off. Okay, so this is going to go in the freezer. We like to freeze them for at least 15 minutes before we fill them. In future videos, we'll show you